This episode of DNews is brought to you by Full Sail University. This week, the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency announced it wants to get solar power from space. I'm having flashbacks to disasters in SimCity 2000. Hello everybody, I'm Trace. Thanks for watching DNews. Back in the 1960s, American aerospace engineer Peter Glaser proposed launching solar panels into space and beaming that power that they collect back to the surface for our use. Since the late 1960s, the idea has been in a kind of a holding pattern, mainly because of the expense and worries about maintenance and equipment. But thanks to recent developments in solar panel tech, the Japanese space firm JAXA says they can finally try it. The plan is ambitious at minimum, and cost, we'll get to there. But JAXA is determined, and they are not the only ones. The US Naval Research Laboratory is also interested in space-based solar, as are some private companies. The reason everyone's looking up is because that's where the sun is. If we can put a satellite in orbit to collect the sun's rays before the atmosphere filters them out and without the worry of a cloudy day, that would be rad. The JAXA Space-Based Power System, or SBPS, will orbit 22,400 miles up, and if done to their specs, would completely replace a nuclear power plant by producing 1 gigawatt of electricity, enough to power 500,000 homes or a large city. Their plan uses a 10,000 metric ton system, which is pretty ridiculous, actually. The largest rocket ever launched was the Saturn V. It took our boys to the moon, and it could only lift about 130 metric tons. Once the power is gathered, a converter in space will convert the electricity into a microwave beam. Not like the one in your house, it's literally waves of energy that are on the micro scale. Microwaves can be converted from energy at 80% efficiency, which means that there would be some loss, but it would be pretty damn good. About 48% of the power collected would reach consumers at the end of the line, which doesn't sound great, but actually that's pretty good. To make sure the array is getting sunlight 24 hours a day, JAXA plans to put mirrors on either side of the planet, super easy, to reflect sunlight at the collector all the time. The Japanese are announcing their plan so far in advance in the hope that other countries will gather and help realize the dream of solar from space, because once created, it could provide clean, unlimited energy to anywhere on the planet, regardless of remote location or whatever. Here's the kicker though. It would cost about $1 trillion, which sounds like a lot, but it's really only about 125 bucks per person for everybody on the planet in 2030. And that's way less than you're all paying on your power bills anyway, not to mention oil wars, pollution, ecological damage, mining and drilling that goes with fossil fuels. We've got commenting areas, so go down there, check them out, type your feelings on space-based solar so we can talk about it. But none of this would be possible without computers to run the system, and we need people to write computer programs. Full Sail University in Florida offers courses to help train tech professionals by blending code and real-world experiences. Students of Full Sail have hands-on access to technology on their very first day. They get a discounted laptop and all the software they'll need to earn degrees in software, mobile, and web development. To find out more and support the show, go to fullsail.edu/dnews. Thanks for watching, everybody.